Welcome to Up, Up, Down, Down. I'm your host, Austin Creed, and you guys have been so good. You've been so great, and we're at a million subscribers, so you got a gift. Look, it's Stephanie! I'm so excited!
Thank you for being on. We appreciate it.
Thank you. Thank you for having me.
Of course, of course.
I am a terrible video game player.
No!
I'm a bad gamer.
You've got this one under control. We're just punching things. We're playing Streets of Rage 2, and we're so excited. But first things first, everyone on the show has a nickname. So what would you like your nickname to be?
So I thought that I was going to say my nickname because you told me in advance that I needed to have a nickname, but I'm actually going to ask you to name me.
Oh. Ooh. That's so much pressure.
It is. You're stalling.
I am.
It was a stall technique.
It was.
Better was seeing him do it.
Yeah, this arm up, he's just grabbing himself.
He really gets into it.
I know, boss lady. It's so easy. I know, right?
Come on. You're totally. You have a totally different name, Austin.
Mine's
Creed.
Austin Creed. Mine's an actual like name.
Completely different.
I need. Okay, here we go. We can form nicknames from. Give me like a random funny story from childhood, and we'll name you off of that. Does that not work?
No, you were like throwing it back on me. Just to say the first thing that comes to your mind. Come on.
Steffi Steph? That's not good. Queen Bee.
Queen Bee. No, that's Beyonce.
Okay.
Right?
Well, I mean, she's a queen in her own right, but you're also a queen.
I'll just be the queen.
The queen.
The queen.
Okay.
All right. I mean, it's pretty straightforward, but I'll take it. I'll be the queen.
But like, people will say it in a regal voice. It's like, ladies and gentlemen, the queen has arrived. Stanford,
you're
Connecticut.
Good with the queen.
Nope. Okay. All right. So we're playing Streets of Rage 2, guys.
All right. Blaze.
Yes.
Actually, I'm Blaze. You could have just said that.
You know, that's what we'll do.
It would have been easier.
Blaze. And we're gonna keep every bit of that.
Look at this. Pshaw. So, I love how I can throw the fire.
See, you said you're a bad gamer.
I am.
How so? You're.
So my brother, this is a true story, we used to have, see, this is what I'm talking about, I hit you.
But you just Germaned him.
Well, that's because I hit a lot of buttons all at once. My brother used to have a hammer next to his Nintendo. For his anger.
Wait, what was he hitting with the hammer?
The Nintendo.
What?
Yeah, it was not a particularly, it's supposed to go down. Not a particularly bright move.
I was going to say, so he hit it once, and then that was it?
No, several times.
But like,
he destroyed it. He, like, smithereens.
Would he get another one and destroy that?
I only ever saw the one.
Okay. I was going to say, did you have, like, any anger issues, like, playing video games?
Oh, yeah, because, you know, the games lie. You know that, right?
How do they lie?
They do. Like, when you don't, like, you push the button, you're clearly hitting X to jump,
yes.
Right? And then it just doesn't jump when you hit the button. Liar. It lies.
So that's what you've dealt with, is the lying video games.
Yes, absolutely.
So you don't trust them.
No, I don't trust games at all. That's why I'm not a gamer. See?
You know, we're going to have to find you a game that you can trust. I think you can trust this game, because you're already good
know.
At it. You're already crushing it, killing it.
That's because I'm playing a good character.
Blaze, you're playing yourself. This is you in Fight in the Streets.
You know what I'm saying? That's me.
You're crushed. You don't get many street fights, though, do you? I would imagine. Lady of her caliber.
In the main streets of Greenwich?
No. Yeah.
No, I have. I must say, I haven't.
Been a while.
Been many. Although I will tell you a story of myself. So
perfect.
I was in, I don't know, like middle school. Mm-hmm. And I dared a girl to punch me in the face.
Can I ask why?
Because I was stupid. It tends to run in my family, I think. And she did.
Yeah.
And she hit me in the nose pretty hard. And I realized right in that moment, and I couldn't do anything back because I had dared her to do it, right? It was just such a foolish thing.
Were
and
you
I
guys
was like,
friends?
Yeah.
Okay.
You know, not like best friends or anything.
You
like
knew.
Acquaintances.
Yeah.
And I just thought to myself, God, that was so stupid.
Yeah.
Like, why did you do that? And, you know, I can't answer it. But I definitely learned what it felt like to get punched in the face. And I learned that I didn't want to get punched in the face
again. No more. I definitely don't like this.
No, that is not a good feeling. Hey, where'd you get the pipe?
A guy dropped it. You can pick up the knife.
Okay, how do I pick that up?
So when you hit circle.
Circle.
There you go. Now you get a knife. And also, too, when there's apples on the ground or turkeys or anything, you can pick those
Slice.
Up. Because your health is low.
So then that'll up your health back. Yeah.
Wait a minute. Can I stab this person? What's going on?
You can't. So you grabbed him, so hit circle again. And you'll throw him on the ground. If you grab somebody like that, press circle and show
hurt.
But
how come I can't use the knife?
Oh, you can now. So you can, if you hit circle, it'll stab.
Oh,
there you go. There you go. Mm-hmm. From the streets.
From, see?
Mean streets.
Mean streets? Connecticut. That's what I'm
So having this girl punch you in the face, did that kind of help drive you towards what you currently do? Were you like, hey, you know
what? Hey, yes, I like getting punched in the face, and I get like to do this on a regular basis. No, but I always wrestled with my brother.
Yeah.
You know, and so can I ask you a question, though, for a second? Can I pick up two knives?
No, you can only pick up one.
No?
I wish you could.
Only one knife.
I wish.
There's several knives on the ground.
You're asking great questions, though.
Okay.
Yes.
All right.
Oh, there's a turkey, so if you go pick that up.
Oh, turkey.
Oh, he got you before you could get it.
Am I dead?
No, but you come back with full health.
Oh.
So you're fine.
Can I eat the turkey now? What
do I
do?
You can eat it. Press circle.
Circle.
Yep, and she eats it right there.
Circle is the magic thing.
Circle does everything.
Got it. Circle of life. So my brother always basically stretched me, which of course is, industry terminology for submission holds.
Yeah.
And he'd throw me about the you threw a knife! You would throw it!
So when you have the knife or any other weapon, if you hold this button, and then press this.
Oh.
So that button is also jump.
Which button?
This button. Button? Yeah.
You there didn't you go. Tell me these things beforehand.
But see now, no, because we're on the next stage, so you're getting more advanced.
Oh, okay. Well, I'll throw fire. I'm not even hitting anyone. No, the game. Oh, see, take that. Or that. Did you see that?
Look at that. Back handspring, kick him in the face type of stuff.
Yeah, but I'm not quite sure how I'm doing it.
But the thing
I'm
is, you're doing it. It's the fake it till you make it type of thing.
That's right.
You know, it works out for everybody.
It does. Oh, there's a pumpkin. I ate something.
Oh, I wanted to ask you. So, remember I was telling you before at that video game tournament, the guy won, ended up making $20,000 and giving it to Connor's Cure. He did a big check ceremony, and I was there and
yes.
accepted for everybody.
Thank you.
Oh, of course. Connor's Cure is amazing. So, like, I know we've told this a million times, like, your inspiration for it and how much it means to you and things like that, but, like, when you meet new people
yes.
that haven't heard of it and you're telling them about it, there was the one time we went to the children's hospital and you're explaining it to everybody. Like, I don't know if you guys know this, but there's like this glow that comes across her face with like such happiness explaining what this charity is and like what it means to you. And I'm just interested, like, how does that feeling never go away? It's like always it's the first time that you're talking about it.
I don't know, because there's nothing more important in this world than children. And Connor, to know him was to fall in love with him, yeah. And oh
yeah, she's bad.
Wait, I can't talk about Connor and play a video.
Okay,
game.
Fair.
I mean, I'm sorry.
Fair.
He's
fair.
He's too important.
Fair.
But Connor, he was just amazing.
Yeah.
And I kicked you. Sorry.
Oh, all good, all good.
And I truly, I feel that he came to WWE for a reason. He was a WWE fan for a reason,
yeah.
And it has nothing to do with anything that we've done.
Yeah.
It is all Connor and his spirit.
Yeah.
And he's just pure light and love. And then you meet all these other kids, and
yeah.
Unfortunately we've lost so many kids too, mm-hmm. like Drax and another friend of mine, Elijah. But then you also have kids like Kelsey and Lance who are doing really well, and all the kids that we all get to meet. I mean, a lot of people hear me talk about our mission,
yeah.
which is to put smiles on people's faces, but when you get to do that, I mean, all
oh,
of our superstars
thing.
Know. I
yeah.
mean, there's nothing feels better in this world than putting a smile on a child's face,
yeah.
especially someone who really needs it. And to think that in WWE that, you can help a child forget that they're sick,
yeah.
even if it's only for a few minutes, And then you think about their parents seeing their children, forgetting that they're sick, not feeling sick, and having fun. It's such a gift.
Yeah.
It's such a gift.
Yeah.
And I can talk about it all day. I'm not being super eloquent right now.
No, that's fine. It's real emotion. Oh, if we hit this and there, you're back in.
Oh, because I had died, right?
More. Yeah, I was dead too.
Well,
it happens.
We were doing something
more important. It
happens.
Yes.
See? But when I'm... Oh, hey, let me go.
Something happened to me.
Jump.
My guy's freaking
Liar.
Out. The controllers are messing up.
You know what I'm
they
saying?
They are messing up.
Okay, but can I
we
also
take
tell
that.
You?
Yes.
I have a weird magnet issue thing.
What's the magnet issue?
Like
you are a magnet?
Hotel key cards don't work well on me. radios will go to static when I walk by. What? AM, like AM, FM, like old school. But yeah, like technology, like the thumbprint technology won't work on me.
Is it like you have like a ghost?
Like, I have like a magnetic field thing.
And this has been all your life?
All my life.
That's
insane. And apparently there are some people who just have this, because our IT department, I'm like one of three or four people in our company that just have random issues with technology that nobody else seems to have. I'm not responding at all.
Mine messed up too. So
I'm serious.
Yeah.
This is what
happened.
Black cloud.
This is what happened. We're gonna let this play. You know, we'll just talk for a few minutes. It's fine. Okay. So interesting. So talking about stuff with kids and everything. When we 2-3 weeks ago, we went down to Orlando for the Pro Bowl, and then Rollins and I went. We did stuff with a bunch of the players who were in the game, and just asking them like, what's the coolest thing about being a football player? And, like this and that and this and that. But the stuff that they did earlier that day was their Play 60 program.
Yeah.
Or hanging out with all
the
kids.
Yeah, that's right.
And whenever people ask me, and I know you like you have the same feeling, like when I was a kid watching wrestling, I had this grand thing where I loved the lights, the cameras, and like these larger-than-life characters, and it was just so awesome. And that was my favorite part. But now actually doing it, that stuff is still amazing to me, but the coolest part is being able to like see those kids in the front row, like who were me.
That's right. I know exactly what you're saying. Yeah. And that's the part of WWE that people don't understand. We have this crazy connection to our fan base.
Yeah, it's wild.
You know, and it's like people don't understand that our audience actually dictates so much of what we do. Mm-hmm. You know, whether it's in the ring or it's storylines or it's merchandise or whatever it is. You know, our fans are a part of our show, and without them, we don't have anything.
Yeah.
And we understand though also as entertainers, right? What that means and what that feels like. So in WrestleMania, you know, when you have your WrestleMania moment, it's not just the person in the audience that says, I was there. It's the person who's performing that says, I was there.
Yeah.
And it's this connection, right, that we all share. And it's something that I don't think exists in any other brand.
No, it's very interesting, especially so like, coming from your background, like, did you have those moments of like watching the show and feeling that way, or was it different for you being in?
No, it was always that way.
Yeah.
You know, and because I grew up watching all the time, and I'd go to Madison Square Garden like, you know, every month or whatever it was, and then we'd go out to dinner, you know, and it was always late, and it was always a bunch of, you know, talent around,
guys.
And it was rowdy and fun, and I loved every second of it. But my parents would make me go to school the next day. Mm-hmm. My dad had this expression that was a little bit crass, but basically it said, if you're going to be out, you know, you've got to be able to fulfill your responsibilities the next day. So even at like 10, you know, I had to learn that lesson.
You're like, oh, I'm so tired.
Oh, it was terrible. But, you know, when you grow up like that, you grow up thinking that, you know, you're smarter than all your teachers.
Yeah.
And, oh, yeah, because I'm so savvy. And then life kind of smacks you around a little bit. You realize you're not as smart as you thought.
But I feel like having that kind of experience as an adult now, like, you've learned so many things that it takes people so much longer to learn. Because, like, you essentially have to, like, grow up a little bit faster because you were around all that stuff, yeah?
Yeah, I mean, I guess you do grow up faster because you're exposed to so many different things
and
so many different people. But, you know, it's... life's a journey, right? And I'm just excited to be on mine. I'm loving every minute of it.
Loving every minute of it. That's Blaze for you.
Has there ever been a time where the controllers didn't work?
Once.
Oh, and who was it?
It was Joe.
Oh.
Samoa Joe.
Really?
But it was like...
maybe he has the same...
He might. But his the whole system crashed.
His might be more powerful.
He's got the magic
aura like
about
subtle.
Him.
It's
more of like a charm situation.
Yeah,
you watched Charmed
like
back in the day? Okay, witchcraft stuff. What?
Yeah, no, I know what it is, but I didn't get to watch it.
Okay, I'm obsessed. Like, Charmed, the Golden Girls is my show.
Golden Girls? I love Golden Girls.
It's so good,
I
right?
used to watch Golden Girls every Saturday night with my parents, and I'd eat, like, Haagen-Dazs ice cream and sit in the big overstuffed red chair, and they'd be on, like, the sofas. Yeah.
That's so good.
It's so fun. With a little afghan, my mom would have a little afghan on, and she'd keep going back in and getting the butter pecan. I think that was her favorite.
So it's just family time watching Golden Girls.
I love Golden
Sophia
Girls.
Sophia Blanche.
Yes.
Are you watching anything currently? I know you've got such a busy schedule. Do you get
I watch Netflix. I binge watch. So and when I do cardio, I'll either read or I'll watch TV. And I finished Sons of Anarchy last year. I love Sons of Anarchy. And then now I'm into House of Cards.
Oh, it's so good.
It's so good,
it's
right?
So good.
I'm in season 3.
Okay.
Just to give you a little feeling where I am.
We can talk. Spoilers are coming. So if you don't want House of Cards spoilers, do not continue watching.
Spoil it.
I'm not going to spoil it for you. No.
Okay.
So this is beginning of the second season. So you know how he makes friends with the reporter, makes mm-hmm. friends, the reporter girl. And then when he goes to meet her at the subway.
I know, I've seen it. Yeah.
So.
Yeah.
He just shoves her up.
Shocking.
I wasn't ready for it.
And me neither. Me neither. But all of that and what he did to Peter.
Yes.
Right?
Yes.
Was all a setup for that line with the president mm-hmm. in Russia. Well, in Afghanistan.
He's the man.
Right?
He's the man.
Right? And he's like, I've killed a man with my bare hands.
Yeah.
Have you? And then he's like, I think maybe you know what I'm talking about. It's good stuff.
See, I feel like maybe you could have had the role.
You know.
Yeah.
Kevin Spacey. He's got one up on me.
So when I started watching that show, I didn't know what it was about, essentially. And then in the first 10 minutes when he, like,
kills the dog.
It hit me like in my soul.
I know. You can't kill a dog. And then he tells the owners, like, he just didn't.
Yeah. It's like, come on, man.
I know.
So
that was horrifying.
Yeah.
But then I couldn't, because the same thing, right? Yeah. I hadn't mm-hmm. seen it, so I wasn't sure. And then I'm like, was he putting the dog out of its misery?
Yeah.
Was he helping them or was he not? And in my gut, I kind of.
But you want to kind of make excuses for
you
him?
You want to. I think that's human nature, right? Like, no, he just meant well.
So when you binge watch, are you just right in that show, or do you kind of binge watch across the board like other things?
No, no, I gotta be in my show.
Focused. Yeah, completely focused. Yeah. Okay, movies. Your favorite movie?
Two favorite movies.
Okay, two.
Princess Bride.
Ooh, hell of a movie.
And True Romance.
What's that? I haven't seen.
You haven't seen True Romance? Oh my gosh, Tarantino wrote it, I believe.
Okay.
And it's Patricia Arquette and Christian Slater.
Okay,
and,
I'm in.
And Christopher Walken and Brad Pitt.
Oh, Christopher Walken.
And it's just this all-star cast.
Yeah.
And it's this great storyline. You have to see it. It's totally crazy what happens at the end.
We're watching it.
It's awesome.
We're going to revisit
it. You have to watch it and then give, like...
I'll give the review. Yeah. I'll
tell you what. If you watch it, I'll come back and we can talk about it.
Perfect.
All right?
Perfect. I love
we
it.
We should technically watch it together. But
hey, if we had time, maybe we could watch it in parts.
Yeah. Have a little Mystery Science Theater.
Yes, we have the shadows, us, popcorn and everything. Okay, so there's a movie I need to check out.
Maybe be entertaining to us and maybe not anyone else.
No, you know what? So Kofi and I streamed ourselves watching the Super Bowl.
Oh, yeah, I know.
Yes. Oh, yeah, because you saw me and my...
Patriots!
Yeah. It was a thing. It was a thing. I'm dating
you were walking
video.
Around.
I was.
Yeah. Oh,
I was.
Are we not supposed to date?
No, no, no. I dated all the time.
Oh, okay.
It's fine. Because yeah. this is
because you were wearing Patriots garb today.
Yes.
Yes.
I had jersey, football pants.
You even had the
socks.
The stirrup. Things.
It was rough. I've been wearing that for 3 days.
Oh, how long? So was it 4 or 3 days? Are you done now?
Yeah, I'm finished. Oh, now that I've got gear on and we're at TV, the bet is done. But whenever someone asked me why I was wearing it, I'd say, because the New England Patriots are the greatest team in the history of the NFL.
Can you say that again?
You know what? You can, like, if you want to rewind it, you can, like, listen to it again
That's
later.
Okay. I heard it. I already know it anyway.
It hurt so bad. Were you watching the game?
Yes, of course I was.
Okay.
Yes.
And Falcons were, they were up.
They were by a significant amount.
Well, what was the roller coaster like for you?
Well, you have to understand, right? I'm also a mom.
Yes.
So, 100%. And
beautiful young children.
Thank you. Thank you. 3 girls, mm-hmm. 10, 8, and 6. And my grandmother recently broke her hip.
Oh, okay.
And she's okay. And she's actually turning 90 at the end of this month.
Yes.
Yeah. And she's feisty as hell.
Yeah.
Like, she's so cool, my grandmother. It's like no filter.
Yeah.
Oh,
that's how my grandma on my dad's side is. Or my mom's side,
it's
sorry.
It's unbelievable.
Yeah.
I mean, the things that come out of her mouth. Mm-hmm. But very entertaining. And we brought the Super Bowl party to her.
Okay, that's awesome.
And I made chili, and we had steaks, and salad, and chocolate chip cookies that my daughter made, and cheesecake, and all kinds of stuff. It was cheat meal.
Hey.
So in between cooking and cleaning, I was catching the game.
Yeah.
So I had the TV on, like, right there, and it was devastating. Well, we were getting killed, but I have to tell you, I never lost faith because Brady always turns it around.
And I have no idea
in the
how
third
that's
or fourth
thing.
Quarter. He always does.
I don't understand.
I mean, the whole team does, but you know, but Brady's the man, right? Like, he just is. He's an awesome quarterback. There are a lot of awesome quarterbacks in the NFL. Ben Roethlisberger is also an awesome quarterback.
Yeah. Matt Ryan is going to be. He's going to get some rings on his fingers.
Yep. There are a lot of awesome quarterbacks, but Brady right now.
Yeah.
He's the man.
Is
I mean, he just is. Like,
it's
and the whole team, you know.
Right.
The coaching. I mean, they're like the greatest combination of people ever.
I can imagine like the noises in your house. There we go. Greatest traveling show on earth.
You know what? Now that the circus...
We're the largest, right?
We will be the largest.
Yes!
Yep.
Yes! We will be. I wasn't sure about that.
Yep, we will be.
I mean,
yep.
Not... Sorry to... But you know...
It's true.
It happens. It happens.
It does.
And we're glad to be a part of it. And you know what? I won't take up any more of your time. I'm going
to
watch this movie, and we'll hopefully revisit it.
We need
Stephanie,
to.
We are so glad you were on the show, that you could grace us with our presence.
Thank
with your
me.
Presence. Blaze.
Thank you. Awesome.
She's fantastic.
I like
Blaze is great.
Blaze is cool.
Blaze is great. When you caught me in the hallway and you said hi, Austin Creed, it wasn't clicking in my head. I was like, oh, nice to meet you. And I was like, why did I say nice to meet you?
Because I saw it. Yeah, I saw you Blaze over. It was pretty funny.
But then it made sense because you never met Austin Creed before.
That's right.
So that's why I was like, let me reintroduce myself.
Yeah, I know. And you tried to play that off. Did. But it was so funny. I could tell I got you.
Yeah.
I was like, oh, I totally got you.
And I was so upset because I'm like, I don't blank. Like, what's happening? She got me. Oh, that's awesome. But again, thank you for being on.
Thank you for having me.
Is there anywhere that you can be reached at social media, somewhere they can follow you?
Absolutely. At Steph McMahon is my Twitter handle, and I'm not sure what my Instagram handle is. Because, you know, of course, it wasn't available at Steph McMahon. So.
We'll have the links in the description below. Also, she's on Snapchat.
I am.
So follow her Snapchat.
Yes, helped launch the new day, helped launch my Snapchat account.
It was a good snap.
Is that just my...
Yeah, just Stephanie McMahon.
Just Stephanie McMahon.
We'll have the links in the description down here, so click the little arrow, and you'll be able to click on her links and follow her everywhere.
Do you see how cute my pooch is? He doesn't realize he's too big for that space anymore.
I was going to say...
Well, he grows about 5 pounds every week.
How old is he?
He's 7 months old, and he's 116 pounds.
My God. See, okay, I'm not even a dog person.
Oh, see this? This picture was taken at the Super Bowl when the Patriots won 2 years ago. It's right there. See, I'm wearing my Patriots hat. See all the confetti. Also, an extremely close, exciting game. Bam. Did it again. That's all I'm saying.
It's painful.
Everyone's gonna make fun of my dance, and I don't care. I'm supposed to, you know, be able to have fun and make fun of myself,
yeah,
right?
Exactly.
I play a villain.
Yeah, and you're supposed to have a good time.
That's right. That's what our show's about.
You could go to like the upper echelon of greatest villains of all time.
Oh, really?
Yeah, that's what you're pushing for.
I wouldn't. I mean, that's what I'm trying.
Yeah.
But yeah.
Because you're not done yet.
I wouldn't put myself in that category.
Okay. Sorry, I know I keep like half ending the episode, but like, so who would you count as like greatest villain of all time? Not just in wrestling. I'm saying. Villains like, Maleficent.
No, like, because she kind of was a babyface.
Okay.
Bit. Like
okay.
You can understand, and that's the thing about great heels, is that they always have a reason.
They're justified in themselves.
Yeah,
yes.
It's for in themselves,
yes.
Right? I mean, she had her wings cut off.
Yes, it's true.
Like I'd say, that was a pretty good reason.
Yeah.
Right, by the guy who became the king.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, Maleficent, she kind of was a babyface.
So
you can't really say she was a heel.
What about? Okay, I don't know any redeeming factors about like Ursula.
Ursula is pretty bad.
Yeah.
Yeah. But you don't really know her backstory, do you?
This is true.
How did she become Ursula?
This is true.
Yeah. Ursula is actually the example that I use for my kids.
Oh, really?
When I was explaining that mommy's a bad guy on TV. And I said, you know, honey, my daughter's name, well, nickname, my oldest daughter's nickname is Peanut, which is the name I was going to choose.
Mm.
And then I thought, that's her nickname.
She'd see it and be like, no, that's me.
Yeah. I would hear about it. But so that's what I used to explain because Little Mermaid was big in my house at that time. And, you know, I was saying, you know, mommy plays a character just like Ursula, you know, and I pretend to be a bad guy, you know. But if there was no bad guy, then the good guy would have nobody to fight against.
Mm-hmm.
And there wouldn't be much of a story.
Yeah.
You know, and then if you watch some of these movies, like the things that they do are horrendous.
They're terrible.
They kill the parents.
They're terrible. Every movie.
Every movie kills one of the parents.
So I don't know if we talked about this. I go to these gaming and anime conventions and we dress up as the characters and things like that, cosplay.
Awesome.
And it's so much fun. And so there was a group of like, it was like Ursula, Maleficent, all the Disney villains. And there was a guy who had like a hunter's hat on and a jacket and like a shotgun. And everyone's like, who is this guy?
The huntsman?
No, it was the guy who killed Bambi's mom. Yeah.
Really?
Yeah, because you
never see him.
Oh my
God. And so they just dressed as this hunter and was like, he's the most evil one of the bunch.
How could they even have that?
Exactly.
That's horrifying.
So to me, it's like, that's
Bambi's
the most,
mom.
He's the most evil one.
I can't even watch Bambi.
See?
I can't. Because
it hurts too bad inside.
It does. It
hurts too bad inside.
Watership Down, also really sad book and movie from my childhood. You just reminded me. Thank you. Now I'm traumatized.
Okay. Last thing. So as we're talking about villains, so you know the story of Dorothy and Wizard of Oz, obviously.
I do.
Yes. So have you seen Wicked?
Oh, yeah.
Okay, perfect. I love musicals, and that, to me, is like...
Oh, I love Wicked.
It was up here to me. That was
because
it's
so clever.
So good, right?
Yeah, just so
good. So good. Oh, she's just hurting inside.
Yes.
She's green,
yes,
and they make fun of her.
Green. And it's like, what? See what I mean?
Yeah.
There's a reason.
Mm-hmm.
And a good one.
Great one.
A very good
great
one. Think about my character. My character.
The things she's been through.
Right?
Yes. So many things.
I mean,
which you can go back and watch on the WWE Network. Only $9.99.
That's right. Do we need to wrap it up? Is that the cue?
Oh, we can. It's whatever time you have. I just talk, and I'll just keep going. People have actually been very curious about what we're going to do for a million. And so, like...
Well, I hope I don't disappoint.
Oh, no, not at all. Because people have asked for you.
Oh, have they?
Yes,
really?
Because they always make a joke like, oh, if you got, like, Hunter or Stephanie on the show, it'd be, like, really funny, but we know, like, they'll never be on the show because, like, they're doing stuff and they don't want to hang out with you. And I'm like,
I like, love sometimes... hanging out with you. Awesome.
Thanks, Blaze.
That's
great.
Terrible.
Okay, and that's the end. Thanks for watching. Like, subscribe, share, all that good stuff. And no matter the circumstances, make sure you always live forever.
It's way more fun to be the bad
keep
guy.
Keep it tight.
Or else this happens.
Oh, that's so good. Thank you very much. It's awesome.